Hola, buenos días. Welcome to Mexico. Today, in this special session, I'm going to share you some of the typical Mexican dishes, fajitas. For this plate, we're going to be using chicken, tortilla, we're going to use some sour cream, tomatoes, onions, paprika, avocados, lemon, and some other spices so we can get a better flavor out of it. So join me so we can prepare this dish together. Something interesting about fajitas, this is not actually a Mexican dish, it's something in between. It's called Tex-Mex because it's originally from Texas. You will see that we will be using a lot of red and a lot of green as well, because this is actually what the Mexican flag looks like. So I'm gonna start just chopping all the vegetables. Then we're gonna put a little bit of the white thing. We're gonna start first with the vegetables and then we're gonna take over the chicken. We don't want it to be really hot. What I like to use when I'm cooking is olive oil. We just need a little bit. We're gonna get the stuff. I will just make sure we have a little onion so we add a little flavor. This is really typical Mexico. Let's follow up with our chicken. Pollo, as we call it in Mexico, is one of the most important ingredients. Actually, in Mexico, pretty much every dish that you will prepare in Mexico has pollo in it. This pepper is really nice. Normally, Mexican food is spicy, so I like to put quite a lot. And then we get some salt, of course. And this is something that we have in Mexico that I like a lot, which is the Maggi juice. We cannot live with this stuff. I mean, we put it on top of chips, pizza. I mean, it's crazy. So we can actually spice it up a little bit. And let's go move on this side of the kitchen. Now, it really starts to smell really good. I will just put our vegetables inside because this is a whole mixture of flavors, so we can put everything here. You know how it goes, it's like, I will try to not make a mess, but you need to, yeah. In the meantime, what we will do is we'll be heating our tortillas. So you can either use a new pan, or I like to use the one that actually was used before. This seems to be ready now. So our tortilla is ready, so we'll put it in the plate. And we get our beautiful Mexican mix. Really nice. Okay. Now this is only halfway over. Now we're preparing guacamole. The first thing you need is avocados. This is how we call it in Mexico, aguacates. This one is perfect color. It has to be really green and yellow in the middle. But actually, any Mexican cook, and my grandmother will kill me if I don't do this, put this inside, because that way our guacamole will live longer. Again, the colors. This is how you know it's Mexican. So we chopped a little of the tomatoes, and I'm using some of the onion that was left from the fajitas. You can also use a little of this green stuff that is always nice looking. Actually, in Spanish, it's perejil. And then we add the final touch, which is half a lemon, so it tastes special and Mexican. If you have children, you can make them help you cook this meal and they will love it. So we can use it to dress our taquito. As I was telling you, it's all about ornaments. So the more decorated, the better it will taste and be flavored up. And then the final touch, something that cannot be missing in our Mexican cuisine, is cream. There is nothing left to say to you. Buen provecho. I will eat my taco the Mexican way. So, buen provecho. It's nice. It's cold, but it's nice. Oh my God, it's good. You wanna eat some?